What's going on, YouTube? It's Derek Santiago, the creator of Hidden Feet Secrets, and today I'm going to be talking about ketosis and the ketogenic diet. A little bit on why I decided to do the ketogenic diet, through my research and just, overall understanding of the body, this particular style of eating and way of eating just seemed to just go with my overall lifestyle. It just works, and I feel like it could work for anybody. You don't necessarily have to like eat meat. You can eat fish. You can be a vegetarian. You can be a vegan, and you can still be on a ketogenic diet. And that's the reason why I just decided to overall do it. I feel like it just fits an overall lifestyle that we all can do, and there's just so many benefits. And in my opinion, this is like a really good way to sustain life. Like, if you really think about it, like this style of eating and this form of eating was how we were eating like thousands and thousands of years ago, and that's how we were able to sustain life. So that's why I like the ketogenic diet, and I'm gonna get a little into what if I'm on my post. What is ketosis? A metabolic state categorized by raised level of ketone bodies in the body's tissue, which is typically pathological in conditions such as diabetes, or maybe in the consequence of a diet that is very low. So, metabolic state pretty much is your metabolism and how the body uses energy. The body uses glucose and fat, pretty much those two sources of energy for the body. Glucose is found as carbohydrates and primarily through sugar, and that's primarily like what our diet is now. Like, the Western diet is like very carbohydrate based, but pretty much what this diet is saying to do is to lower your carbohydrate intake, meaning like lower your sugars and increase your fat. Glycogen is stored sugar. So when the body uses carbohydrates in the form of glucose, it takes whatever sugar it needs at the moment, and then whatever it doesn't use, it stores as glycogen. And that's pretty much how we get, extra weight. What happens when you start to deplete the body of glucose, it starts to deplete itself of glycogen, the stored sugar. So your body's going to look for another source of energy, and what's it going to do is going to tap into your fat storage, and that's how one way we lose weight. Your liver will then take the fat, right, and then break the fat down into glucose. When this happens, the body forms what we call ketones, and you can now use fat and ketones as an alternative source of energy. Now, the benefits of this is not only are you losing weight, but this is also helping to even out, blood sugar levels, because again, since we're consuming so many carbohydrates, we're consuming so much sugar, our insulin levels are extremely high for some of us. So if you're a diabetic and you decide to do this diet, this will help even out. When looking to hit ketosis, you want to be in a diet where you're consuming roughly about 80% fats, about 15-20% protein, and 5% carbs. Right? Like, you want to consume like minimal carbs. Why? Because again, we're using the body. The body is depleting itself of sugar. Now, fats too and proteins can sometimes get a little confusing, because you can actually use both, but you don't want to get confused and consume like a lot of protein, especially like animal proteins, right? Like, like chicken, beef, and stuff like that, because when you consume too much of the protein, you'll get full, and your body can use protein as glucose, and you don't want that to happen, because then it'll just go back to being stored sugar. What you want to do is you want to consume like moderate protein, but protein that's high in fats. So if you're gonna eat like meat, for example, you can eat like fish, like marine life, like has very, very good in omega-3s and fatty acids, and that's very, very helpful for the brain. Beef has fats in it as well. Not really big on pork, but I do like, you know, pork bacon sometimes. That also has good fat. That's a protein, that's meat that has good fats. But you can also consume things like, you know, like olive oil, coconut oil. Like, these are very, very high in fats. You know, flax and chai seeds, those are some of my favorite things to use. Like, these are high in fats. You can use like hemp seeds or hemp protein. Like, there's ways to get your fat intake. You know, you may not get it through foods, because again, like I said, like, everything else that we eat is gonna have a bunch of carbs in it. But I don't want you guys to get confused of consuming like a lot of meat-based protein products, because you can also get, you know, a good source of protein through just like raw vegetables as well. But you know, if that's something that you're still like working your way into, totally fine. Just don't consume so much meat products that you're getting full. You want to stay away from a lot of starchy foods, you know, starchy vegetables, grains, beans, bread. Like, you know, they're real, real starch based, they're real carbohydrate based. Now, I'm not saying you can't consume them. You know, you are still able to consume around like, you know, 5 to 10% carbohydrates. But again, you know, you want to consume things very, very minimally. You don't want to, you know, you want to stay away from like white rice. You want to stay away from like white bread. You want to stay away from a lot of wheats that have gluten in them. You know, everything has to be done in overall like moderation. And the reason why, especially in the beginning when trying to get into ketosis, is because this is a metabolism shift, right? Like, once you hit ketosis, I'm not saying not to be mindful of what you're eating, but your body isn't going to react to foods like how it used to do prior to you being on ketosis, because your body's metabolism will start to use fat as energy and burning fat. Like, this is how people who you see that are just slim naturally, like, that's what their bodies naturally do. You know, the whole fast metabolism, I'm a example that I'm a person who has a very extremely fast metabolism. Like, it's very hard for me to put on size. You know, I know the struggle I deal with, but you know, whatever. So I understand this is what we're trying to get, you know, your metabolism to do. We're trying to get your metabolism to primarily burn fat and use fat as an overall. Another benefit of the ketosis diet that I like a lot is the part where intermittent fasting is kind of included, right? So pretty much intermittent fasting is when you're like holding off for like long periods of time until you eat, which is, you know, very, very beneficial, because that actually gives your body like a good amount of time to actually like digest and process foods, and you're not releasing a lot of energy to digest stuff, because your digestive system requires a lot of energy. So when you're withholding yourself of food for that time period, you know, it's very, very beneficial for the body. A lot of us kind of like go through withdrawal periods because we're so used to just like eating whenever we want. But it's something that you can include. You don't really necessarily have to, but it is a good benefit of the overall ketosis diet when you include intermittent fasting, because of the overall health benefits of just giving your body time to just process food instead of just eating and just, you know, having just food built up on top of food and on top of food. You know, your body can only process but so much food at one time. So even when it comes to like, you know, consistent bowel movements of like, you like actually like going to the bathroom consistently, like the ketogenic diet will help with that. So if you struggle with like actively going to the bathroom, like, it may be funny or weird or think like only old people struggle, like, no, like millennials struggle with it too. Like, from my experience, I deal with it on a regular day basis with clients. Like, people just struggle with bowel movement. It's because of like, you know, all the buildup they have in their stomach. So the intermittent fasting helps with that, and along with the ketogenic diet, because it helps with the blood sugars, it helps with bowel movements, and it's also, you can even like look this up if you don't believe me, but it's also been shown to help studies in like autism and cure certain kinds of cancers, because a lot of these are dietary issues. You know, like medications and certain kinds of treatments are just like a band-aid. Like, a lot of this is dietary. Like, if you switch your diet, you eliminate eliminate processed foods, you eliminate a lot of the sugars that you consume, you drink more water, you eat more leafy greens, you eat more fibrous-based foods, because fiber helps you go to the bathroom, and fiber also helps you feel full. So that full feeling when you eat, it's because of the protein and because of the fiber. Like those are the two that are making you feel like, yeah, I'm like really, really full. All right, so remember that, right? And you could get like high fibrous foods from like oats, raw vegetables, leafy greens, like I stated before. And that's ketogenic diet was introduced to treat epilepsy. Alright? And it was used to treat epilepsy through remedies and dietary remedies and fasting. Like I just overall was talking about before, but I rest my case. And also when you're getting into ketosis and you're on a ketogenic diet, this is something that I kind of like because it forces people to have to drink more water. You will feel kind of dehydrated when, especially in the beginning. And the reason is because carbs hold water. So when you're depleting your body of carbohydrates, you're depleting your body of water. You ever heard people say, like, you know, drink more water, you know, like on boxes, they'll drink a lot of water so they can release like water weight? Well, that's why. The reason why you have water weight is because you're dehydrated. You're not drinking enough water, right? So if you replenish the body and actually give yourself water regularly on a consistent basis, you won't have to deal with water weight. You get what I'm saying? Like, you know, people would just lose about like a little bit more than 5 pounds of just water weight, just off of them just drinking pure water. You get what I'm saying? Now, you also have to make sure that you're increasing your physical activity, even if that's for like 20 to 30 minutes a day. Just, you know, taking a jog or taking a walk along with this diet, like, there's plenty of overall health benefits to this, guys. Like, and it's not hard. You could be you can still eat meat, you could be a vegan, you could be a vegetarian. Like, there's really no overall excuse. Like, you can eat meat, you can cut certain kind of things, like, and then it fits into, I feel like, you know, everyone's lifestyle overall, and it's not so hard. It's really, really simple. It's just, you know, just remembering the overall numbers, you know, 80% fats, 15% protein, 5% carbs, and just, you know, making sure that you stick to that. And then even with the fasting, like, let's say you have like issues with like hunger control, right? Like, you know, I get hungry throughout the day, like, some, you know, caffeine helps, right? Now, I'm not saying to drink like coffee with all this creamer and sugar and crap like that, but you can drink some like black coffee. You know, the caffeine will suppress your hunger appetite. If you don't want to drink coffee, you could drink green tea, or you could drink thyme tea. Like, they do help with the suppressing of overall hunger. So like that could be something that you can do. Or let's say you don't want to fast. Something that I would suggest to people is, like, with me, I have a pretty busy lifestyle. I usually make breakfast like the biggest meal of the day for me, right? Like, I eat like a really, really big breakfast, and that usually holds me for like several hours. Like, I don't usually eat between like maybe like 8 to like 10 hours after that. And I usually eat between maybe like the most is three meals. Like, if I'm eating more than three meals, like, I'm eating real good that day. But I don't really get like hungry like how I used to. You know, I used to eat like 6 to like 10 meals a day when I was just trying to get big and jacked, and like, that's just not the wave. Like, that was a lot of force feeding, that was a lot of bloatedness, that was I'm a slim guy, and like, I like forced myself kind of chubby, like my cheeks just, like, it was crazy. But now, you know, I'm back to like my athletic weight. You know, I'm lean, I'm about like between 5 and 7% body fat, and I feel good, man. I feel energetic, I feel energized. You know, I don't feel so sluggish, like, and I feel a lot stronger. My performance is a lot better. So, you know, guys, I hope this was helpful. I will leave a link below to my blog site. You could definitely get this information on my blog site. And you know, guys, just understand, I'm not here to get anybody.